Welcome to another edition of Dazarian Plays MMOs. Today I'm in Star Trek Online. Thank you guys so much for actually taking an interest in the last Star Trek Online video. As I said, if you guys keep liking it, you keep watching, you keep commenting, I'll keep doing videos. It may not be as often, but I will keep at it as long as you guys are interested. So I'm here just right where I left off at Deep Station K7, and I need to find out what our next mission is, if I can remember how to do it, and we're going to see what lies beneath.
It's clear the Davidians are more of a problem than we initially thought. We know they're in the neutral zone. Now we know they're on Drazana Station as well, and according to Zamara, there have already been deaths there. Mm-hmm. In addition, she indicated that the lower levels of the station were a trouble spot. Those levels aren't used as part of the club there, and they haven't been maintained for years. And Ferengi are, of course, quite reticent to put any effort into maintenance that isn't absolutely necessary. That means we don't really know what's down there. Zamara's code should get you access. Take a lift down and check it out. Previous Starfleet encounters with Davidians have indicated that they will create nests around the temporal portals they use. Mm. So keep an eye out for anomalies. If we find the portal, we'll know where and when the Davidians are feeding. Oh, and I expect it to be messy down there.
Messy.
Don't forget to take an emergency beacon.
An emergency beacon? I don't know what that is. Okay, so let's accept that.
Until next time.
And it looks like we're just going over here to Drazoa Station, which isn't too far away, actually. Just 14 light years away, so it'll be right there. Alright, entering the Drazoa system. Oh, lots of people here. Holy cow. So we're going, I guess, to go ahead and go into the station. This is obviously a Ferengi station, but there's more than just the normal stuff going on here. So that's interesting that there's actually, this isn't just for this mission, this actually exists for other things. So, let me get inside and I'll be right back.
We have everything you need for shore leave. And a few things that you didn't even know you wanted. Shopping, drinking, dining, entertainment. You'll find it all here. And don't forget the 77th rule of acquisition. If you break it, I'll charge you for it.
I love Ferengis. Okay, so I've landed at the station. And right here off the teleporter pad, there is... looks like descend into the maintenance levels. And once we do that, then I get to pick my way crew. Okay. Sir, I'm reading temporal fluxions and triolic energy in these levels of the station. Staying down here too long could be hazardous. The interference also may make it difficult to contact the ship or to get a transporter lock if we need to emergency beam out. Yikes. This level primarily contains power junctions, and EPS conduits for the rooms above us. We need to reach the maintenance lift and take that down to the computer core. Okay. Ooh. Oh, this looks pretty good. The emergency flashlights. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Aha! This book of emergency supplies isn't just lying around. Belen probably bartered with a Nosian pirate for it. I recognize these flashlight drones, hands-free hover systems, then programmed to shift in response to our movements. Not the most reliable design, though. Okay, so now we've all got little flashlights above us that kind of, like, hover and do what they should. So we're going to go... it is dark in here. Kind of adds to the atmosphere. Triolic waves. There must be Davidians nearby. I expect that we will see more as we approach the area with the greatest concentration of triolic energy. Sir, I'm also picking up some intermediate readings from behind the door to our left, however. The interference from the triolic waves are making hard to get accurate scans at the distance. Okay, so what do we do? Find the maintenance lift is still our goal. You can see there's even cobwebs down here, really? So they have spiders out here in deep space? I guess so. Looks like the door is stuck, sir. We'll have to find another way around. One of the side maintenance passages should have an alternate route. What? Holy cow. They do have spiders.
Wow.
I called it. That's funny. That's really funny. Did we get them all? Alright, so we're going to have to find another way around. So let me look around here. More Davidians. And we need to scan this Ferengi. I found that door that opened. This Ferengi suffered from triolic radiation poisoning. It seems that he's been here for a while, sir. Even if the Davidians could use his newer energy, it's still dangerous to be too close to their nest. There's nothing we can do for him due to the temporal flux disrupting the transporters. We can't even beam the body out. Once we get out of here, we can notify the station security. Okay. Here's a control panel. Check the power distribution. Captain, it appears that the maintenance levels are suffering from intermittent power problems. The EPS conduits are probably overloaded due to the temporal fluctuations. This station's pretty old, sir, and many of these components are more than a century old. I'm seeing triolic surges near the maintenance lift and across multiple levels, but nothing that can be considered consistently tracked. So we need to move on. Oh, I thought I saw more Davidians. Whoa, there was a Davidian and he, like, in this piece of the ceiling fell. So like he was trying to sabotage us. Another one. And they just disappear like ghosts. But there's several, oh, more spiders. More in here? So looks like we're still moving forward. Use the proton rifle. What? Gets me. Alright. The Davidians are definitely getting more aggressive. They could have a lair somewhere in the lower levels. If they do, they become increasingly more violent as we get closer to their territory. Yep. The synchronetic proton rifle should have a significant effect against the Davidians. The proton beam mode will be especially effective while the Davidians are phase shifted. Okay, does that mean I need to switch off to a different rifle? Wait, let me see what we got going on here. I've got... And... I don't know what they mean. Oh well, we'll just move forward. Oh, I see. Actually, this very first one is the Spinnick rifle. Let's go ahead and equip it then. Ah, it looks a little bit different, doesn't it? Okay, moving forward. Alright, we're activating a lift. Someone put the lift on emergency lockdown. We'll have to override the lockdown code to access it. Okay, how do we do that? Probably this control panel over here. That should do it. I wonder why someone would lock down the lift in the first place. Wonder why. So we go back, unlock it. Whoa. This is computer core level. Sir, it appears that the lift is stuck. We're somewhere on the maintenance level for environmental controls and waste recycling. We need to track down the damaged junctions on this floor and repair or bypass them before we can take care of the lift to the computer core level. Okay, so it looks like we're going to have to just do a whole bunch of stuff in here, I imagine. Any good? Did it work? Yeah. Ooh, look at this. Oh, we got more spiders. This rifle looks pretty good. It's knocking things down. Captain, the door. We're locked in. Well, that ain't good. It's okay. We're fixing things, so we'll get out. New respawn point. Okay.
Log entry supplemental. The strange power fluctuations are related to the problems in the power subsystems on the upper decks. So I'm looking into the possibility of feedback damage or spikes in the environmental systems. It could take some time to find the problem and make repairs, though. Particularly if I need to use the replicators to create replacement components. Balan is loath to allow use of the replicators for anything more than blood wine and Gramillion sand peas. This is dirty, uncomfortable, and thoroughly disagreeable work. Naturally, as soon as the job involves mucking around in the recycled atmosphere and waste processing, I get the short straw.
Oh, Ferengi are funny. So I found this relay, so we'll repair it. Uh-oh. Ah, more Davidians. I don't know if this gun is making a difference or not. Ah, what is this? Oh, it's a box. Don't care about the loot boxes. So here in a long hallway. Oh, more Davidians. Oh my gosh. And big ones at that. Hit a lawn. Oh, look at that. So, let's interact with this. So we repaired one of the relays.
Barbican, I see you. Barbican.
What the heck is going on? Wow. That's kind of crazy. I don't know what that is. That's weird. It's like something haunting the place. Don't know. We got another relay here. Can I do it? Why isn't it working everywhere? Okay, we acted up the backup relay, so good, I gotta find another. What is it? Who is this guy? He just vanished. Yeah, it's kinda weird. Something's going on. That voice is coming from the communications console on the wall, Captain. Well, let's talk to it. Man, this is messed up.
Hello? Please, you have to help me. I came down here to check on one of the atmosphere regulators. Then someone shot me.
Who shot you? All right, I'm activating the manual override. Try to release lever. Uh-oh.
Log entry supplemental. I've upgraded a few of the components on this level, including remote overrides for bleed valves on environment controls, hollow emitters to expedite further repairs, and security overrides in case of emergency. I'm starting to suspect that the low-level radiation I've detected on these decks has affected the station inhabitants, and that some are showing signs of transient acute schizophrenia and paranoia.
Yeah.
I'll have to maintain contact silence for now, so that they don't interfere while I'm trying to repair the systems.
Once I've corrected the problems causing the radiation leaks, we can deal with the symptoms.
Mm-hmm.
Log entry supplemental. My work here will take far longer than I originally anticipated. Fortunately, I've engaged a safety interlock on the maintenance lift, so no one will come down here without me knowing.
Ah, so he's the one that set the lock.
I found several program errors that have purged the affected subroutines. The work is much easier now. Soon, everything will be under control.
Okay, boy. That explains some of it. Oh, wait. What is this? Check the victim. She didn't make it. Multiple phaser burns and contusions, sir. This woman was murdered. These wounds are still warm. She was killed just a few seconds ago. We were too late. There are no other exits or entrances in this room. The transporters are offline. How could she be killed if she was alone in a locked room? Boy, Darcy's getting scared. Reroute the relay in here. There we go. Now we need to... Oh, more spiders. We need to look for the encryption key. Oh. What is this? Like a computer ghost? Defeat and kill killer and find his encryption key. Well, where did he go? Oh, here he is. There he is, blue, so it's probably a Davidian something's going on. Oh no! Oh no! Oh, come on. Really? So I gotta go back in here, I hope. I don't even know how this works. I don't have to do this whole mission again, do I? Okay, so there's Davidians everywhere, so we're gonna have to just take them out slowly, one by one. Yeah, we don't have to do all this again. We just have to defeat each one of these. And I think it was just that I was like in the middle of them and got really overwhelmed. Now, we still have to find him. Right, there he is, over there on the side. Oh no, am I gonna die again? Come on, what the heck is going on? I guess I got revived here. A malfunctioning hologram. No wonder. The triolic energy would have degraded the program and caused instability, and the Davidians didn't bother it because it had no neural energy for them to feed upon. Sir, it looks like the encryption key for the door might correspond to the subroutine embedded in the hologram mobile emitter. We should be able to use it to open the door. Mobile emitters are still rare outside of the Starfleet, Captain. The staff here must have spent quite a lot of latinium to obtain one. If you ask me, Bellion might be selling more than drinks in Dabo. It would be best if someone keeps an eye on him, but I have a feeling Franklin Drake is doing just that. Okay, so we need to take this, yeah, and I think we're going to be going up here, take the lift to the computer core. Okay, this is it. We've made it to the computer core level. On this station, the core itself is down a long ramp area past some regulator rooms. We should head there as quickly as possible. Agreed. Examine the door. Another locked door. This one doesn't seem to have any special codes. We should be able to open it from the secondary security console just down the hallway. Of course. Here it is. Oh, more Davidians. Oh, is there one down there or something? Yep. Ah, the big one is down there. My little minions here do quite a bit, don't they? That should do it. We need to double back and secure the door that we saw earlier. Yep. Oh, we've got another body here. Sir, this person is from the 23rd century. The Davidians must be bringing their victims through time. We have to stop them before they're responsible for any other deaths. They could disrupt the timeline. Wow, crazy stuff. Oh my gosh. That is a lot of Davidians. Oh, that would have been bad. If I recall the details of this sort of station correctly, sir, the computer core usually has intrusion countermeasures defense to prevent enemies from stealing and sabotaging critical computer elements. Perhaps with tactical training, you could reactivate those defense to assist in fighting the Davidian incursion. Maybe. I don't know what she wants me to do. Okay. So we're gonna fight more of these guys. Activate this, aren't we? Yeah, come on, yeah. Tactical, activate computer core defense. Because I'm a tactical officer. Very good. Came to another door as we descend. This station goes deep. This appears to be a regulator room for the computer core's power system. The Davidians are probably leeching power from the station that could keep this gate active. We could use the console to set up a power spike that we could trigger near the computer core, which might disrupt the Davidians in their gate. Okay. So we should do that. And there's more dead people and more Davidians. Let me get through them. Activating that spike thing. Uh-oh. Is that it? Yep. And we'll head on down. And one more. This looks like a field control station for the lower levels of the station. We could set up a field system here so that we can activate them to computer core area to counter the Davidians' phasing ability. That would push them out of sync with our universe. Okay. So we're going to go in there and do that as well. Wow. As we get close, you can see there's lots of dead people. These are definitely from the 23rd century. You can tell by the uniforms. So we're going to have to go ahead and fight these guys now. Hard to tell what's going on. I feel like a Ghostbuster with this gun, though, because it's got that squiggly wave form of a projectile. I guess this is probably the final guy we have to kill. Sir, the Davidian's time portal heads back to the 23rd century. There's no telling how much trouble the Davidians may be causing in the past, where the technology to detect them just doesn't exist. Once we get readings on the portal, we should take them back to the Deep Space K7. Their computer facilities are far more extensive than what we have here on the disaster, and they may be able to find a way to shut down the portal. Okay. Oh, here's the portal. Let's see, so let's scan it. The distortion from the portal is intense here, and it's difficult to process all the information. We should at least be able to compensate enough to beam out, though. We need to take this information back to the nearest station, K7, for analysis. Their computers are powerful enough to process it. All right, let's beam out then. Okay, so I beamed out, warped to K7 and docked, and now I'm here at the center part of the station, and I'm going to go ahead and analyze and scan the data here with their main computer. This is a Starfleet fleet station, so we have access to that. Preliminary analysis. Temporal incursion consists with Davidian time portal technology, approximately link date, star date 2715.6, Earth standard year 2265. Davidian portal based on phase shifted tachyon spin supported by draw of Drozona station power supply. Can the portal be safely closed or used? Portal suffers from instability due to quantum particles entanglement with the phase shifted particles. Portal can be enlarged or accessed with modulated directed energy with phase shifted entangled matter reaches critical point. Yeah. Starfleet talk. Sir, this means that when the triolic energy surges peak, we could remodulate an energy weapon, even a hand phaser, to use the portal to travel back in time. We could stop the Davidians at the source. Ooh. Alright, so we need to head back to the ship.
Approximately oh, no, we where don't. They are focusing their attention, I see no other choice than to send you and your crew back there to stop them before they kill again. I'll be honest, time travel is a tool. At times, it is a useful one. I know Starfleet has hundreds of regulations about temporal incursions, but my job is to preserve the Federation, not make Admiral Quinn and the rest of the suits at Starfleet Command happy. If we break a few rules along the way, so be it. I need to make some preparations before you can proceed. I will contact you when the time is right. Drake out.
Drake out. All right, so collect
until
the rewards.
Congratulations.
Ah, good. Level 22. All right, so that's going to wrap up this episode. Pretty interesting stuff, and we'll have to do another episode because we're not done here because very interested to find out what's going on. I hope you enjoyed this. Make sure you hit that like button and leave any comments you may have. It helps me know that you guys are enjoying these Star Trek videos as well. And if you haven't already, make sure you're subscribed. If you love MMOs the way I love MMOs, then you definitely want to be subscribed because I try to put out an MMO video every single day of the week. And you can get notification of that if you're subscribed. So, till next time, bye.